Okay, just working on a 640D header. The reel fell down kind of yesterday. And if you look, well, it's hard to tell. There's a shaft that comes through. There's the shaft down low. And then it looks like back there it's got a centralizer. So that shaft end hooks inside this. And right here is just the sleeve, because this shaft here turns in the sleeve. So that's why when you grease it. But somehow that was wearing on that shaft until it just wore right through. We should have obviously caught it way before this, but didn't. So here we are. Anyhow, we got it up on the chain hoist, and then we're going to take this end off so that we can pull that out of there and then push this shaft through, and then we're going to look for a new one or either try to do that or weld it. So we'll see what we come up with. Okay, so we just took the end off, moved the reel, pulled the reel a little bit that way, slid that collar like this out of there. That slid out easy. And then we took the shaft to the press and pushed it out. And making sure, because this is all rough and gored, we didn't want to push it that way. So we pushed it through, and we only had to get it started. We were able to pull that right out. So that is the shaft that's hooked to the shaft that's broken there. So we just phoned that shaft is a day or two away, and it's $930. So we're gonna pull this plate off and see how bad it is and pull that whole thing out of there. And then we could either try to weld it or get a new shaft, or we'll see what we decide. Okay, so we took that end plate off and we just marked it so we kind of know the orientation. And then that was the piece that was inside. And then this was the piece that slid through here. And you can see, obviously, that didn't happen in the last 50 acres. It was that way for a while. So somehow this was inside there. So now this is worn. But I have yet to figure out why this can't be welded to that. So anyhow, doing some brainstorming if I'm going to try and just weld this shaft and then weld this to here and slide the whole thing back in there. And then I can slide this over top. Like, I can see how they had it all in pieces if you were to try and kind of do it yourself. But because I got the gantry, I call it, with my two arms, like I got two hoists on there so I can hold the reel up with one and then I grab the arm with the other. I mean, I don't know why I can't slide it in. I'm sure there's a reason. Because this can still... That's probably the part why they have it in two pieces. Because then you can push that in and then pull it back out through there when you have that slid through there. Gotta try to weld it though, because I'm sure that's $930. Then I'd need the plate, whatever that is, and then if there are shims. So we'll see what I can come up with. Made it this far. Okay, I'm just reassembling this 640D header where this main shaft broke. So I'm just looking at the other end and shims in there. And I could see maybe how that weld behind the shims on that side, if them shims wore on that weld over time, and then it could get a crack. And as soon as it could crack, well, then it could start to like kind of wear in there type of. So maybe that was. So all I did this morning, because that shaft is solid, I just reattached my strap from this arm because they were all loose, and then just hooked it around there so I could pull this out, because I'm convinced that all these pieces have to slide on here. And then I'm gonna have to take that, slide it off the end, put it on here, and then slide the whole thing back on the arm, as best I could tell, because anything else you'd do would be a super pain. So I'm just reattaching these arms. So I slid the new piece in here, And then I'm just going around reattaching the arm. So I will video all that. And then as I put the pieces back on, and if we take that off, I'll try to video some of that, because I'm sure that's going to be the ticket to doing this. So, okay. So I just took the hydraulic ram off the back of that piece right here and just let it hang. And then I slid this piece off of here, slid it on there, but it actually looks like that green piece is in that way. I'm hoping that when this slides back, so I had 5 shim washers and then I put 3 in there to let that piece go in more. And then I'm gonna have to lift this up and tip this in and try to fit them down in together so that I can get it to slide back, because I don't think I can pull the reel out anymore. And the more I pull the reel out, it's gonna get it off kilter that way then anyhow. So I think this is the bit of the trick part. I'm sure maybe if I had to, I could pull this pin and pull that bolt back there and then slide this arm up and out of the way and slide it in too. But we're gonna try it this way first. Okay, I did what I said, tip that up, tip this up, fit them back together. It was just, it's hitting on that top, on this top Teflon piece back there. So I'm just pulling it out a little bit more, and then I know it'll go. So I'll just do that off camera. I didn't bring my tripod out this morning. And then all we want to make sure is that that's the right amount. If it's not, that'll kind of suck. So I'll have to pull it all back apart and change the shims. Okay, that actually all worked reasonably well. There was no real fight there. So I'm just going to put this piece back on. I got to make sure that my reel is set up the same way with this. So I'll try to get that all aligned how I had it before. Put the end cap on, hydraulic ram. So yeah, the rest is kind of just bolt up. I'm going to check in with you one more time. Can't talk enough about how the double arm here on the gantry system, that was a big plus. You can do it without front end of a loader tractor, ratchet straps, whatever you got to do to hang that up kind of deal. But you definitely need something to hang that there, or in my mind, you do it. Really made it easy, so, or easier. Okay, so I'll finish bolting this up, and then I'll check in one more time. Okay, just got it all bolted back together. Went fairly well. These reel pieces are a bit of a pain, but whatever. It all worked good. And then I just had to make sure that was in the same pinhole as the other side, so that all the fingers were the same orientation. And then the only thing that I would say that I did wrong on the whole job is definitely them spacer washers. I needed to put 2 in there instead of 3, because it pulled this inner part of the reel in that way, and then that half moon keeper, I couldn't put the washer on the inside of the keeper. And I know that's not the way it's supposed to be, so shame on me. I'm leaving it that way, because this thing has to be out in the field in another 3 hours today. So this winter, I can take it all apart again, and I can put 2 spacer washers in there, and then I can have this washer on the right side of that keeper. Other than that, the job was fine. So she's ready to go back to work. Okay, hopefully that helps somebody. Have a good day.